Hemen Kapadia is now joining us. Hemen, any view on SR Oil delisting last day today or in delisting charts don't work?
Oh, well, honestly speaking, you said it yourself, Pankaj. I think if there's delisting happening, it's beyond, I think, the purview of, like, you know, like natural disasters and acts of war. Probably delisting is another thing which needs to be added to the list where, you know, technicals don't sort of play out properly, Pankaj.
Right. Sun Pharma, any view? 5% decline. Opened at the day's low and now closing at the day's high. So again, proves that, you know, investors are very loyal to this name.
Yes, I think a gap down opening is obviously a little bit of a nightmare for a technical analyst. Having said that, this gap down, okay, it's recovered some of the gap, no doubt. But the gap down is a negative technical, so it's expected to provide resistance, and that's why, you know, we're seeing those Sun Pharma has recovered from the day's low, no doubt. It's struggling a bit, so till this gap gets covered up, outlook will be a bit cloudy. But like you said, Pankaj, you know, after this, if it bounces back the way it has, yes, loyal investors, and one gets the feeling that today's low should hold for the timing.
Right. You know, opening at the day's low, closing at the day's high always tends to, you know, make a technical analyst believe that at least the bottom has been made.
If you're taking a very near term view, yes, Pankaj, and a bottom has been made today, today's low of around, you know, 7730. And if you look at a slightly medium term view, you know, the 75-50 level, last time it went to 75-40, this time it went to 75-51. So that level has held then from a slightly medium term point of view, and yes, short term point of view, the low of today, Pankaj.
Right. What would you, you know, what would be your view on Kaveri Seeds? It's down 10%. I mean, from the high of 1,100, it's now down more than 70%. Any view on this name?
It continues to remain in a intermediate downtrend, Pankaj. It has been, like you mentioned, since the peak. So it continues to remain in an intermediate downtrend, which is probably not yet over. We are oversold, but that oversold hasn't worked much. One gets the feeling that, okay, we're already at 350. Now we are getting to a very rather solid congestion area, Pankaj, between 350, what we are. There's something at 337, and finally at, you know, between 350 and 300, there is a six-month consolidation congestion area in 2013, which I think should cushion the fall. I believe, okay, at the risk of sounding presumptuous, I believe this is the last stage of the fall. The fall is not yet over. We've been making new lows regularly, and that series has not yet ended. But despite that, one gets the feeling that there's a last stages of the fall. And after this, one would see a decent, if not a good, recovery. But there's no sense in flagging off a buy one, because we've posted a new low. Two, we continue that intermediate downtrend. So once a reversal comes in, that time I'd be more open to saying that, boss, we are ready for a 200-point bounce back. Not yet.
Right. But in the near term, what according to you should be the low? 337?
It's a big range, Pankaj, between 350, 337 and finally 280. I'm not saying it's going to 280. But it is a worst-come scenario possibility, which I would rather not rule out. But, yeah, almost every 10 rupees, Pankaj, between 350 and 280, there is some support. Because this was a sideways consolidation phase in 2013 for almost 5 or 6 months. So, I know it's a big band. If you say 350 to 280, that's 70 rupees, that's almost 20%. But
right.
That's how it is.
Right. But as of now, don't touch this name.
No, I think probably a week or so down the line, 2 weeks down the line, maybe we'll have more clarity. But like I said, we've been down from 1,050, maybe another $50 more, but that's about it.
Right. You know, how would you look at Adani Ports? There has been some sort of action over there, but again, it gets muted, you know, every time it tries to go to the 260 level. You think it's in a very, 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 very strong range and very difficult to break that range at this point of time?
One gets the feeling that time being the worst is over when it posted a low of around 240, Pankaj. I think there's a huge short position. We saw some short covering, probably not enough. But the open interest was significantly large, so one gets the feeling that short position is still there. But yes, I think closer to 262 is the technical level where we walk into very strong resistance. But I have a feeling that we could probably take this out and go a bit higher. Is this the bottom? I'm not sure. Time being, yes. Medium term, we need a test of the bottom. But we've been down for almost 17-18 weeks, Pankaj, from a high of 374 to 240. So One would not get too unduly bearish. You're right. Every time it comes to the 260, 262 level, we have a virtual roadblock, which is it's in the process of working to take out. So not bearish, not very bullish either.
Right. Marico, what will be your view? One of the best performing stocks after results, similar to Adani Port, but on the opposite side.
Yeah. Now, Marico is in an established long-term uptrend, Pankaj. This has been for the last 14 and a half years. So it's pretty different from Adani Port. One, we don't have that much of history in Adani Ports. But so this continues to make higher tops, higher bottoms on the quarterly and monthly charts. Even now on the monthly charts, we saw a slightly scary situation for Marico when it went to 380. But now we've sort of come back and we are almost at its all-time high, Pankaj, which was at of around 400 and... we're sort of almost there at the all-time high, Pankaj. 466 for the earlier all-time high.
Right.
So we're actually poised. There's this range between 380 to 466, Pankaj. If we take this out and sustain, logic says that we'd give a 80 rupee move, but we'll just have to wait and see whether it absorbs this selling from the previous high very easily or no.
Right. So tomorrow it gets X bonus in the ratio of 1:1. Does that change anything on the charts?
No, that won't change anything. The charts will get adjusted. Sometimes if it gets X dividend, Pankaj, the support resistance levels change by the amount of dividend given, especially with a large dividend. But the X bonus won't change the picture. Just the scale needs to be adjusted.
Right. But volumes would tend to pick up. It will become a much more tradable name. Any sort of premium for that name? Because Venky's, got X bonus today, and that's seen a big move because of that.
Yes, you're right. One participation would improve. And yes, if liquidity improves, like you said, more participation, that much less whipsaw than that is. And that would be that much more easier to sort of, analyze moves, especially if it's a heavily traded stock.
Right. But as of now, it continues to be in an uptrend. Any decline should be used as a buying opportunity for Marico?
As of now, yes, but I'm slightly reticent because this move has come on from 380, Pankaj. 380 to 466, that's 80 points. So, like I said, if it takes out 466 and sustains, we're looking at another 80 points. But is it going to retrace this rise from 380 to 466? Slightly difficult to take that call. So, I wouldn't have a one-way view as of now.
Right. A one-way view on IGL. After years, it is broken above 500 and looking good after that level as well.
We've 5.5 months, Pankaj. It's a range between 430 and 520. If you sort of cut off the tops and bottoms, the range is between 450 and 510. So we're just at the top of the range. We have not broken out of this range in 5.5 months, but it seems almost training at the least, so to speak, Pankaj. So 510 is fine, but if we take out 520, we are heading for a 10% upside.
If we take out 520, and again, would just like to reiterate, these are cash levels and 520 taking out as in 520 on a closing basis.
Yes, and cash levels, and just one more point to what you said, it's a weekly level. So, ideally in a utopia, we'd want to wait for the week to end before this call actually comes into action. But if you wait for the week to end, it might go better. But yes, these are weekly levels. So going by pure technicals, we need to wait till Thursday evening because Friday is a holiday for the weekly charts to end, and that would quantify a breakout above 520. And yes, after closing about 520, it needs to sustain and remain above 520 from a closing point of view. Otherwise, that call is null and void.
Right. But overall, at this point of time, you would wait for 520 and then buy rather than buying it now.
No, I think I'd stick my neck out and say it's worth buying now because it's a risk worth taking because it's 10 rupees away. So I'd keep a 10 rupee stop loss at maybe 500 and try to play the 10 rupees also.
Right. Any view on GAIL? I mean, that had a similar rally to start with. It went till about 360 odd levels, but now coming back to the 340 mark.
Okay. Normally the PSUs are difficult to comprehend because of whatever happens.
That's why we're asking you, Hemen. Because it's difficult.
Pankaj, that's not fair. Because I'm not a crystal ball gazer. Probably you'd know more about government companies than I do. But yes, I think, okay, we've seen an intermediate recovery, Pankaj, which sort of has stalled. That's fine. The levels are 335 and 370. So if 335 holds in the near term, okay, we're 2 rupees away from that. If it holds in the near term, I think that's a small positive. Below 335, there is support at 330. So there's not much to lose. It's not looking exciting either. I think it's drifting down after that rise from 275 to 370. So currently not much to look at. If 335 breaks, 330 breaks, I think that's a warning bell.
Right. What would you view ICICI Bank as? After days, we've seen it topping the chart, probably a good move coming in throughout the day, opened at the day's low, now closing in towards the day's high. How is ICICI Bank looking?
A much delayed bounce is underway, Pankaj, like you mentioned, after a long time. We've been down for what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, almost 13 or 14 months, Pankaj. And we've sort of come back from supports at just below 240. So yes, near term, I think it looks positive. Yes, a further upside can be expected. Sustainable, too early to take a call on, but as of now, the short-term picture has definitely improved.
Right. Any other view on names like Axis Bank, which have also started the move up, but not as strong as ICICI now?
Okay. Axis Bank is probably a one step behind ICICI Bank. ICICI Bank was one of the earliest private sector banks to weaken. Now, Axis Bank is following suit, but yes, I think a delayed recovery in Axis Bank is also on the anvil. Like I said, maybe ICICI Bank is a shade better. But Axis Bank may be two steps behind, but it should recover because even the Bank Nifty, even the PSU banks, suddenly all the banks are looking fine.
Right. From the PSU lot, do you like PNB? It's one of the top losers, at least in, you know, if you would categorize by the market cap and then try to assort, you know, which PSUs have given better returns. It's one of the top losers. Do you think the room for upside or surprise over there is much higher?
To be honest, I'm not sure if I have an answer to your question, Pankaj. But if I can talk about two other stocks in the PSU basket, which...
Okay, which ones can you tell us are looking decent?
I think State Bank is looking relatively better. I'm not saying much better. A simple way of analyzing, Pankaj, PNB made a new low vis-a-vis the last 3 months. State Bank hasn't, despite coming close. So a little bit of relative strength coming in. That's why I'm telling you PNB. Sorry, I'm telling you State Bank of India. That looks interesting. And one another stock which has made a low but is deeply oversold is Can Bank.
Right, Canada Bank, you mean?
Canada Bank, yeah.
Right. You know, Bank of Baroda on the fundamental side, I mean, is one name that everybody likes. You know, people who are underweight on the PSU banking space also like Bank of Baroda because of the changes that are happening over there. You think that this is a name which can do well? And it's also held a lot of strength compared to some of the other names.
Yes, Pankaj, I think you're absolutely right because it is the, I believe, the strongest, if not one of the strongest PSU banks going pure by technicals. I'm not a fundamental person, but yes. So it has held its own. It's not broken the lows. It doesn't look very exciting in the sense, it could recover. So I don't have a pattern to justify a buy or a recommendation. But yes, it has been clearly one of the better or the best PSU banks around.
Right. So you would be overweight on this name? If one has to play the PSU or the private ones that we spoke are looking much better.
Either we can play on its relative strength and expect it to bounce back with the rest of the market, or take a risk and go for one which I've got hammered more and hence the bounce more. So if I were to have a pecking order, I think ICICI Bank, Axis Bank, State Bank, and then Bank of Baroda.
Right. What would be your view on M&M? I mean, we all saw the news flow coming in about, diesel car. It went to the lows of 1,210 odd level, but a very good bounce in the last 2 days, 80 odd points, 80 odd rupees rather.
Agreed. But in the bigger scheme of things, it's slightly inconsequential, Pankaj. It's been between 1,100 and 1,420 for almost 14 months. So yes, the bounce was there. But the bigger range remains unscathed on either side. So till we see a breakdown below 1100, which doesn't look like happening, or we see a breakout above 1420, which also doesn't look like happening. So it bounces around like a ball within a range. So I'm not sure if there's a clear view or to make sense of this. Yeah, maybe there was a knee-jerk reaction to whatever has happened in the Delhi NCR region. And now we are seeing short covering or a bounce back or profit covering or whatever.
Right. Hemen, thank you so much for taking out time for us. Always a pleasure talking to you.